Hello everyone, welcome to Sarushi classes. So in this lecture we are going to read Tamil Nadu board class 12 history chapter number 18, that is the Justice Party rule. So let's get started. The Justice Party rule in Madras presidency constitute an important chapter in the history of South India, and the ideology and the objectives of the Justice Party had been unique and somewhat different from those of the Congress Party. The Justice Party represented the non-Brahmin movement and engineered a social revolution against the domination of Brahmins in the sphere of public services and education. So, how the birth of the Justice Party took place. So, various factors had contributed to the formation of the Justice Party, which represented the non-Brahmin movement, and the social dominance of the Brahmins was the main cause for the emergence of the non-Brahmin movement. Their high proportion in the civil service, educational institutions, and also their predominance in the Madras Legislative Council caused a great worry among the non-Brahmins, and the Brahmins had also monopolized the press. The rediscovery of the greatness of the Tamil language and literature also provided a stimulus to the non-Brahmins, particularly the publication of the book entitled A Comparative Grammar of the Dravidian or South Indian Family of Languages by Robert Caldwell in 1856 gave birth to Dravidian concept, and later the ancient Tamil literature had been rediscovered and printed by various Tamil scholars including Arumuga Navalar, C.V. Damodaram Pillai and U.V. Swaminatha Iyer. V.K. Kanakashibhai Pillai, in his famous historical work, The Tamils 1800 Years Ago, pointed out that the Tamils had attained a high degree of civilization before the advent of Aryans, and this led to growth of Dravidian feeling among the non-Brahmins. These factors collectively contributed to the birth of the non-Brahmin movement and Justice Party, and the precursor of the Justice Party was the Madras United League, which was renamed as Madras Dravidian Association, and this happened in the November 1912. Remember, the Madras United League was renamed as Madras Dravidian Association in November 1912, and Dr. C. Natesa Mudaliar played a significant role in nurturing this organization. So, in 1916, the South Indian Liberal Federation was formed for purpose of promoting the political interest of non-Brahmin caste Hindus, and the leaders who stood behind the formation of this organization were P. Thyagaraya Chetty, Dr. T. M. Nair, P. Ramarayan Nigar, that is Raja of Pangal, and Dr. C. Natesa Mudaliar. So, the South Indian Liberal Federation published an English newspaper called Justice, and hence this organization came to be called as Justice Party. Remember, the South Indian Liberal Federation published an English newspaper called Justice, and that's why this organization came to be known as Justice Party. And the other newspaper which supported the Justice Party was Dravida, that is in Tamil, and the Justice Party organized a series of public meetings, conferences, lectures to popular non-Brahmin movements, and similarly, the Justice Party formed district association, the non-Brahmin Youth League. Now, something about the Justice Party rule. So, Justice Party came to power following the elections of the 1920s held according to the Montagu-Chelmsford reform, and Justice Party captured 63 out of the 98 elected seat in the Madras Legislative Council. As P.T. Thyagara Chetty declined to lead the ministry, Subbarayalu Reddiar formed the ministry in the election of 1923. It fought against the Swaraja Party, and the Justice Party again won the majority, and the ministry was formed by Raja of Pangal. In the election of 1928, a divided Justice Party faced opposition of United Congress, and therefore an independent A. Subbarayan, with the help of Swaraja Party, formed a ministry In 1930, when the next election was held, the Justice Party won the majority and formed a ministry with B. Muniswamy Naidu as the leader. So, in the 1936, the Raja of Bobbili replaced him as the Prime Minister of Presidency. In 1934, Raja of Bobbili formed his second ministry, which continued in the power until the election of 1937. So, what are the achievements of Justice Party? Justice Party remained in the power for a period of 13 years. Its administration was noted for social justice and social reforms. Justice rule gave adequate representation to the non-Brahmin communities in the public services, and it improved the status of depressed classes through education reforms. Justice Party introduced following reforms in the field of education. So, first is free and compulsory education was introduced for the first time in Madras. Nearly 3000 fisher boys and fisher girls were offered free special instruction by the Department of Fisheries. Midday meals was given at selected corporation schools in the Madras. And the Madras Elementary Education Act was amended in 1934 and in 1935 to improve elementary education. Next is, the education of girls received encouragement during the justice rule in Madras. Education of the depressed classes was entrusted with the Labour Party Department, and encouragement was given to Ayurveda, Siddha, Yunani and medical education. Now, the government took over the power of appointing district munsif out of the control of the High Court, and the communal GO, that is government orders of 1921 and 1922, provided for the reservation of appointments in local bodies and educational institutions for non-Brahmin communities in increased proportions. So, the staff selection board created by Panagal Ministry in the 1924 was made the Public Service Commission in 1929, and it was the first of its kind in India. The women were granted the right to vote on the same basis as was given to men, and the Hindu Religious Endowment Act of 1921 enacted by Panagal Ministry tried to eliminate corruption in the management of the temple. Justice Party government introduced the economic reforms to assist the growth of industries. State Aid to Industries Act 1922 was passed, and this led to the establishment of the new industries such as sugar factories, engineering works, tanneries, aluminium factories, cement factories and oil millings and so on. So, this act provided credits to industries, allotted lands and water. So, this proved favorable for industrial progress. Similarly, Justice Party government introduced schemes for rural development to help agrarian population, public health schemes to prevent diseases, to improve village economy. Village road scheme was introduced in the city of Madras. The town improvement committee of the Madras Corporation introduced slum clearance and housing schemes as social welfare measures. The Justice Party government gave waste lands in village to depressed classes. So the Devadasi system, a disagree to women, was abolished. The Justice Administration reorganized the working of the University of Madras. During the administration of the Justice Party, the Andhra University was established in 1926 and Annamalai University in 1929. So, this was about it. So, after this, there was the end of Justice Party rule. So, the Government of India Act 1935 provided for the provincial autonomy, and the electoral vice victory meant the assumption of a major responsibility in the administration of the province. K.B. Reddy Naidu led the Justice Party, while C. Rajagopalachari led the Congress in the South, and in the election of 1937, the Congress captured 152 out of 215 seats in the Legislative Council and 26 out of 46 in the Legislative Council. So, in July 1937, the Congress formed its ministry under the C. Rajagopalachari. Thus, the rule of Justice Party, which introduced important social legislation, came to an end. In 1944, the Justice Party conference was held in Salem, and their Peraringar Anna passed a resolution, thereby the name of Justice Party was changed as Dravidar Kalangam. Remember, the Justice Party was changed as Dravidar Kalangam. So with this, we have come to an end of this chapter. Do subscribe to our channel. Do hit the like button. Do share these videos with your friends, with your colleagues, and anybody you want to share with. And do click on the bell icon so that you will get notified when I'll upload next video. Thank